You see how I squished it here and it broke here. Where is it? See? Yeah, just snap right off. 'Cause I squished it too hard, and of course it'll stay there. And yeah, I could put a drop of epoxy right there, but I'm gonna take it all apart and do it all over again because I know now I need 9 beads for a size 8 ring. There. There you go. Yeah, so we'll take that apart. Okay, so let's back up to the beginning, okay? All right, now what I'm gonna do right now is make a nice little. It should be down here, but I know I'm gonna take it apart, open it up, and flatten it down. And I just might this time use a piece of half round wire. Yeah, so remember the end is like this, right? And that's kind of bunchy, 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 even though it is underneath your finger. So I'm going to take that back apart, lay it on top of the other wires going this way. Remember, it's in a circle now. It's in a circle. So you got end wires here, and this one is over like this. I'm going to take this apart, overlap them, and maybe put that half round on top of them, then you could trim that closer. You could trim this closer, and you trim the half round wire underneath, or if you want on top, since it's underneath your finger, up to you. Okay, so let's give that a shot. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave plenty of room there so I can take it apart easier, okay? Push down and twist, and push down and twist. There you go. That's it. Okay, let me straighten the wire. Okay, I straightened my wires out. Hurry, Tosh. Hurry, hurry. Okay, hold. Where'd I leave off? This way, huh? Put the one in the middle. I separate them so that bead can go all the way down and be really snug. Hold that hard against this finger and these two fingers. Bend to the left, bend to the right really tight, and we're gonna whip that around really fast and whip this one around really fast. So we're here. I know it's gonna look ugly for a second, 'cause we gotta squish that down. Come on, and bend this wire. Squish and bend. I know, we'll fix that later. Okay, let me put my next bead on. Okay, all of this can be fixed later. So the important thing is now. We have to learn to hold and squish, hold this down as much as possible. Put that finger under there to hold it, right? And whip it around. And whip it, I mean, not around, not around, just it's over, over and over. Okay? And then we're gonna whip it, whoops, whip it around. And pull that one and whip it around nice and tight. Okay, see how it came out better the second time? Now, as long as you stay focused and in a rhythm, excuse me, as long as I stay focused and in a rhythm, it's always going to be nice and tight. See? And we'll figure something else about that later. I don't know. So I'm going to go back to this one and push it down, even if I have to get the pliers. Push it down, push it down, all the way down. So now I'm going to take all the beads off the other ring. And you come over here. Or if you want, you could wait till you're all finished. with all 9 beads for a size 8 ring. All 9 beads for a size 8 ring. This is a 4 millimeter bead. Okay, and then you can straighten it all out. Push it down, push it down, push it down. Okay, there we go. There we go. Now I gotta take the rest of my beads apart and put it on. See if I can do it. I think I can. I think I can. No, I can't. No, I can't. Okay. Ah, don't drop. Don't fall. I don't want the baby to eat you. Ah, can't find the damn hole. Don't you hate it when you can't find the hole? Okay, there. And let's keep going. Over. Sometimes the most simple patterns are the most difficult for me. So I decided to change that pattern of the ring my sister Dawn sent me and make up my own. Oops, oops, oops. I'm losing my bead. Hang on, I'm losing the bead. I gotta see. Oh, come on, hurry. Get on there. Thank you. You know, when it's all finished, you touch it up, everything later, right? Swoop to the right, swoop to the left, stand up, sit down, fight, fight, fight. There you go. Oops. I gotta figure this something different for this. I think I'm going to take that apart, pull that straight, and then when I get to the other side, loop it across each other and bend and bend. Oh, come on, Tosh. I can't see. Okay. You got to hold it down. See how that's puffy? Next time I make it, it won't be puffy. But that's okay. Spirit just put this idea in my head. Cross over, cross over. Right? Bend around. Bend around. And as you do it, it'll get better and better and better. And even when this is finished and you put it on the mandrel to size your ring, some of the space is going to get taken up as you turn it around the mandrel. So I'll be back. So see, as you go along, see how it's really sloppy there? And as you go along, focus, hold everything together tight, twist. Twist fast and twist fast, then it comes out nicer like that. Next time I'm gonna go around twice and put a little doodad between the beads. So in the meantime, this is just gonna go like this for right now, and then I gotta whip it in shape. Come on. Okay, I'm gonna swing that around a couple of times and swing that around a couple of times. Okay, and then I gotta swing this around a couple of times too so it will stay. So let's cut that down a little bit, but need a workable size there. Okay, and I am going to do it like this a couple of times, and then I'm gonna, well, right now I'm going to just smash it with my pliers. See, I put it back on the mandrel, make sure it's all nice and cozy. Figure out the rest later. Okay, so I went around twice, right? Okay, let's just, because you know, whoever gets this, I don't want them to have any problems with it. Would you get in the hole? Get in that hole right there. And then smush it down, smush it down. Now I'm going to make sure I cut it really close so this won't be pointing down, just in case I don't cut it enough. I don't want any pokey bits on anybody's finger or mine. See, so we're just going to put that down. Ah, come on, hurry. Like that. Okay, and then I'm going to take this, wrap it that side, take this, wrap this side, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to trim really close, just have enough room left. Okay, so let's tuck these down. Push it down that way. I don't want it to go all the way under, just in case I don't crimp it enough. I don't want any pokey bits touching you or me. So I'm going to cut it really close. Cut it really close. And then we're going to take our pliers in here really, really tight. Did I cut that side? Okay, don't matter. Let's go. Come on. Thank you. And we're going to take this and we're going to squish and roll. Okay? Squish and roll, squish and roll. Hey, so Tasha, what about this? This is from the beginning, remember? I'm just going to take one at a time and turn and next and turn and then pinch it down, all the way down, pinch it down, pinch it down, all the way down. Let's see. Okay, that feels pretty good. Feels pretty good, guys. Don't ask me why I'm always whispering right about now. Okay, see, so there, okay. Come on, get your butt down. Come on. Pinch it down, pinch it down. All the way down. There you go. I'll figure out something to do with this, how to do this better, the beginning and the ending. But for right now, that's easier for me to do than, yeah, the tutorial. Do it again.